You know, the one thing that I'm really bad at is cutting things.
So, for all P5 and P6 students who have learned about the water cycle in Upper Block Cycles textbook, but find it very difficult to answer questions on this topic, it is very important that you watch this video and clear all your misconceptions first. In this video, we are going to learn about water in the forms of water droplets, water vapor, and steam. So first, let's look at water vapor and steam. Both water vapor and steam are water in the state of gas. However, what's the difference between water vapor and steam? For water vapor, it is something that can coexist with water in liquid state. So that is, it can be existing in room temperature. However, for steam, it is something that we define as the gas that water turns into when water boils. So water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Steam must be at 100 degrees Celsius and above. Also, steam does not coexist with water in liquid state. Right, so water vapor can coexist with water in liquid state. Steam does not coexist with water in liquid state because it is only existing after all the water have boiled at 100 degrees Celsius to turn into gas, and that gas is called steam. Water vapor, however, is when water evaporates, which can be at room temperature, so it can coexist when water is in liquid state. So, for example, room temperature. One thing that all of you must be very clear with is that we cannot see water in the state of gas. Okay, we cannot see them at all. They are in the air. They are not visible to our naked eyes. So we cannot see them at all. Let's do a little recap now. Can we see steam? Can we see water vapor? The answer is no. We cannot see them at all. So what we see are tiny water droplets. When you see water boiling, you see tiny water droplets that are actually suspended in air. So these tiny water droplets, they are actually in liquid state. So we can see them when they are in liquid state. It's basically water in liquid state, just that they are so tiny. So these tiny water droplets, they can suspend in air. Some of the example we have here, cloud, mist. Okay, what you see when water is boiling, what you see is not steam. I repeat, not steam. Exam, they like to ask you questions like when they say ice cream from the fridge, or when you breathe out in a cold country, or when water is boiling, there's this mist that is in the air. What is that? It is not water vapor. It is not steam. They are tiny water droplets. These are what we learned today. Remember, you cannot see steam. You cannot see water vapor. You can only see water in liquid state or in solid state, which are ice, or in liquid state, it can be tiny water droplets. It can be just water in your water bottle, for example. And this will be part one of this topic that I'm going through, because I think that I also want to create another video on the water cycle itself. I will share more on the water cycle and also the boiling curve of water, which is essentially something that you will definitely learn in secondary school. But I see a lot of related graph kind of questions in those primary school paper as well, so I thought it would be nice to go through with you. And if you are already in secondary school now, this will be a nice recap for you as well. Please stay tuned, come back and watch my next video. One way you can subscribe, if you subscribe and hit the bell next to it, you'll get notification for all my new videos. You will get to see my next video. I'm going to share on water cycle and the boiling curve of water. Thank you for watching. Yeah, I hope you will have a better understanding of this when I'm done with the video.
Subscribe to my channel. Thank you. If you find this useful, after you watch this, I would strongly suggest you subscribe.
Because what matters most is you understand. I explain to you, and that if this help you understand, please subscribe to my channel. Subscribe.